see from the title, we are doing another one of my top 10 videos, but today we are doing the top 10, not 1, not 2, not 3, not 4, not 5, but top 10 most underrated players in the NBA today. This is not all time, this is not all time, this is not all time, this is in the NBA today. So, well, I guess NBA of last season, because next season hasn't started yet, so of this season. I guess over the past couple seasons, I guess for some of these players, but who are just the most underrated players in the NBA today. So, with that being said, let's jump right into the video now. Again, this is my, I always say this in the beginning of every video, this is my opinion. This are based on things that I think are very important to being a successful player. Some of these players on this list are already big names, but maybe big names that need to be more appreciated in the NBA. And among peers and things like that. So, whether that be all-star teams, whether that be MVP voting, maybe that just how good a player is overall. Like it's just how I feel about these players and how I feel like these players are viewed in the league today. So, again, this isn't official. This isn't written in stone. This is just my opinion. You have your opinions, and that's awesome. Please let me know your list or your some players that you think are also underrated in the NBA. There's a whole lot of them, and a lot of them are going to be missed off this list. So, with that being said, let's start off with how I usually start off these videos, and that's sharpening my pencil. Even though this pencil doesn't look like it needs to be sharpened that much more, but I'm going to do it anyway. Make sure you guys can hear that. Oh, I got some pencil shavings everywhere. Respect on his name. Assist Also, I mean, the man is just a pure scorer. He shoots like around 35% over his career from three-point range. He's a great free throw shooter. He's a great passer. He's averaged almost 7 assists a game. He's averaging 27.7 assists and almost 5 rebounds a game, which is amazing for a guy at his size playing, you know, in Phoenix and only being 22 years old. So, again, definitely should be an all-star this next coming year. I'd be very disappointed if he doesn't take another big jump like he just did this past season. So I can definitely see Devin Booker. I don't think he's underrated. Well, I think he's underrated, but not to the content of the people above him. You know what I mean? I think he could definitely make an all-star team. He should make an all-star team. I think it's just team success isn't there. So I think once this Phoenix team gets going and gets, you know, more development and better players, I think Devin Booker will start getting more recognition that he's deserved and maybe make some all-star teams, all NBA teams, and then maybe we'll see what happens down there in Phoenix about, you know, winning not only regular season but beyond that. So yeah, next up we have actually kind of hard to say because I think he was on the all-star team this year, if I'm not mistaken. If not, he should have been. But this player was also ranked on my top centers list in the NBA. I'm sorry if you guys can't really see this on my camera. So hopefully he is healthy and can play very well next year for them. And again, a player who is known around the league, but again, pretty underrated. He's a top 10 center in my head. But it seems like you don't really hear a lot of buzz around him just because, again, the team he's on, where he plays, the team success. But individually, I feel like Nikola Vucevic could definitely become a very, very, very good center. Again, he's only 28 years old. He signed a four-year, $100 million deal this offseason. So he is determined to stay in Orlando and try to win there. But I feel like he will either plateau or he will increase, but maybe he'll get worse. Again, he's 28, so he's on the little bit of the older side, but hopefully he'll be, you know, more impactful this next offseason, because in the playoffs, he didn't really do that much against Toronto. He averaged 6 points, 6 points, 11, 11, 22 points. Yeah, he didn't really do that well in any of the games against Toronto in the playoffs, so he needs to step up and definitely become better this offseason. And next, we have number 8, which again is another player who I feel like is a big name, but definitely not top about the way that he should be. 8, 7, 6. Okay, let's put this up a little bit higher. Let's put this thing off. Oops. Sorry about that. Last season. Yes, the man led the league in rebounds last season and wasn't even on an all-NBA team, all-defensive team. I think he wasn't even on one. Didn't make an all-star team, didn't do anything. You know what I mean? So, I think this one is purely just team success. Andre Drummond should be more of a highly reported player, in my opinion. He's 25th in PER rating out of 24. He's averaging 17 points per game this last season with 16 rebounds. He's averaging as many points as rebounds. That's insane. His assists are very low, though. He's only averaging about 2 assists a game. But again, this man needs to be more talked about and recognized, in my opinion. I would love to have an Andre Drummond on my team. I'm sure a lot of players would, or teams would. But I think he has a pretty big contract still down there in Detroit that he signed not too long ago. Was actually the player that I wanted the Blazers to draft before I figured out how good Damian Lillard was. So, I mean, Andre Drummond's a good player. He's still only 26 years old. Yes, he's only 26 years old. 26 years old. And I feel like he still has a lot of room to grow, definitely offensively. He definitely needs to work on his shooting a little bit better, like his mid-range. And his free throw shot needs to get a little bit better. But, man, this guy is extremely good. I feel like he could impact the game on a very good contending team. In the playoffs, he's actually performed pretty well, but again, they went against Milwaukee, so, like, yikes. center. I don't like Julius Randle at the center position, even though he probably will, because I don't think they have, well, they have, what's his name? I can see his face. Mitchell Robinson. So I think he's going to start at the four, which is perfect. That's exactly where Julius Randle should play, in my opinion. So that's why the Julius Randle and Anthony Davis combination work so well. So you have Julius Randle and Mitchell Robinson playing up against each other. It's perfect. So, again, just a player I feel like, just if he had more playing time, if he had more, I guess more offense with him, he obviously needs to improve his, you know, shooting abilities. I think he only averages like 70% from the free throw line, and he's upping his three-point percentage to like a 33-34%, which is good. Could be better, yes, but I really hope it does, because, like I said, he just needs to get, you know, a better playbook, I guess, maybe. But I feel like this next season he will shine, because a lot of people clowned on this offseason, and that again makes him super underrated, because everyone was just making fun of him because, you know, the Knicks signed him. So I really hope he comes out and plays very well. Next, we have number six. Also, sorry if you guys can hear my neighbors upstairs. It is currently midnight. Again, it's midnight, and this guy is stomping around his apartment upstairs. So sorry if you guys can hear that. Honestly, super annoying, but the show must go on. And I definitely should have made these names a little bigger, but I very much apologize. But we have number six. And at number six, I have, let's see, yeah. A player who just recently got a big contract, but in my opinion, he is still very misunderstood in today's NBA, and that is Tobias Harris. I get it. If you see Tobias Harris as a small forward, he doesn't have the glitz and the glamour of most small forwards in today's NBA. But, if you see Tobias Harris as a power forward, his true position, this man averaged 20 points, 3 assists, almost 4 assists, and 8 rebounds. This man's averaging almost 20 and 10, and can play the stretch 4 position, which is such a key position in today's NBA. Definitely needs to be more recognized. I feel like he's definitely the perfect for any team in the NBA. He can shoot the 3-ball. He's a very good rebounder, as you can tell. He's averaging 10 rebounds. He's shooting 40% from the 3 throughout the playoffs. He played pretty good. You know, he's averaging around 20 points per game during the playoffs. And I just feel like people just didn't see his new contract as being fitting for him, just because, you know, everyone thinks, oh, Philly's just, you know, blowing their money on these players just because they need to get the team together. No, I feel like Tobias Harris is a perfect for any team. Does he need max money? No, but then again, Philadelphia probably should have paid for max money, because they don't want to give up Tobias Harris for anything, so. Alrighty, so now I am in my top five. Now these ones are pretty hard to think about now. This top five group could definitely be thrown up in any way, shape, or form. But, I'm just gonna go ahead and put this player up next, just because he's probably the youngest out of everyone on this list. So I'm gonna put him at number five, just because I feel like he definitely has more room just feel like he's very underused, and the Pacers' offense, especially during the playoffs last season. Now, again, I think they were going small ball with going against the Boston Celtics, so I think he didn't really have him on the floor that much, but man, this guy could definitely be the starting power forward for a lot of teams, or probably every team in the NBA right now, without, you know, counting out the superstars and stuff like that, but I feel like he definitely could be, you know, used more. I think he only averaged like 24 minutes a game, 25 minutes a game. I also think he came off the bench most of the season, if not the whole season. It's pretty sad. He definitely needs to start. And if he doesn't start, man, if I'm Domantas Sabonis, one of these upcoming off seasons, whenever his contract is expired, I'm going to be wanting to start, or I'm leaving Indiana if I'm him, because he has so much talent. And it's, I think he definitely needs to start. I think being off, coming off the bench, I think they have Miles Turner, who I think has placed the center position, which I guess isn't a very good idea nowadays in today's NBA. Guys over 6'11", 6'10", at the same time, but Sabonis is a pretty good shooter. He shot 15% from the three-point line, which is very, very good. He shot 60% from the field goal, so, and his free throw percentage is 70%, so he has a jump shot at any way, shape, or form you want to look at it. And I just feel like he has a very good key on defense. Obviously, he could be better, but he's only 23 years old. He's so young. He could get better. I think he will get better, and I think definitely needs to be known more as a top power forward in today's NBA if he got the minutes. Okay, next we have number 4. Again, I apologize if you can hear my neighbor upstairs. Super annoying, super loud. I wish I could tell him to stop. These next 3 are pretty hard, but I feel like this next guy, I have to say, and I feel like this is kind of like a tribute to Damian Lillard. I think this guy has talked so much about being so underrated that makes him not underrated anymore. And that would be Mike Conley Jr. I think he added that this past season or something like that, but Mike Conley Jr. Mike Conley was averaging 21 points per game, 6 assists, and 3 rebounds per game this past year, and in my opinion, will be one of the key reasons why the Jazz actually perform very, 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 very well this next season. Mike Conley is a floor general in every retrospect of the definition. His PER rating is, you know, top 50 in the league. He has a very, you know, formidable three-point shot. It's 37%. He's a great free-throw shooter, and his steals and his defense are one of the best in the league. He averages almost 2 steals a game. I feel like he's definitely a great player. assist and 8 rebounds now. I feel like he definitely has gotten more recognition just based on the fact that he made a All-NBA team. But, again, a player who I don't think made an All-Star team this year. Zach LaVine. Now Zach LaVine averaged 24 points per game, 5 assists and 5 rebounds, which is pretty good for his size. Again, I think he's kind of undersized. I think he's probably around 6'5", which is pretty small for a shooting guard, but a player who can probably play the 1 or the 2. The only thing you can really knack on Zach LaVine is that he's not very good defensively, but again, he's only 24 years old, which will come to him as he grows bigger and develops more of a basketball IQ. He's shooting 38% from the three-point range, almost 85% from the free throw range, which is insane. But I think he's definitely developing more and more into a player. I think next season and the seasons to come, now that the Bulls actually have a direction that they're going in, you know, they have Kobe White, Zach LaVine, Lauri Markkanen, Wendell Carter Jr. You know, all they need is a good small forward. I think they have Otto Porter Jr., if I'm not mistaken. If not, then I apologize, but I think they have a pretty good three there, if I remember. But the Bulls have a direction, and I think Zach LaVine can definitely be the charge, be the head of that Bulls team, if he really wanted to, alongside Lauri Markkanen, in my opinion. So I think he's a great scorer. I think he just needs to add a little bit more to his game. But, I mean, he's not very much talked about. Again, not any All-Star games. I think he could definitely make an All-Star game in the Eastern Conference now that the East is a little bit weaker. Obviously, you know, Zach LaVine's one of the greatest dunkers of all time. Like I've said before in my past videos, the top 10 dunkers, he's amazing. But I think he just needs to add a little bit more on the defensive side. And I think he'll be more recognized in that manner of being a good player, which I think Zach LaVine could definitely be, you know, a number three on a championship contending team. But I don't really know when he's a free agent. I don't know if he signed a big contract or not yet. I think he did. But I think Chicago is a good place for him. I think he'll be the best player for actually had a kind of a worse regular season this offseason now in the playoffs. CJ McCollum was amazing. He averaged like almost 30 points per game. He did amazing in the playoffs, but for the regular season's sake, he definitely didn't really even take a step forward that I would have liked. I think he pretty much just plateaued or even digressed a little bit, but this postseason he really showed that, you know, he really deserves that big contract that he's getting this past offseason. So I believe in CJ McCollum. I think he's good. I think a lot of other people think he's good. He could definitely make an all-star team if, you know, I don't want to say this, but I'll knock on wood again. If other players got hurt, I think he could make an all-star team, but I don't think he's really that underrated anymore. Buddy Hield is a great scorer. Other than that, he's not really, I don't really see him being anything super good. I think he's a great player for Sacramento as of right now, but I mean, I think he'd be even a better sixth man for a championship contending team. Just my opinion. He's just a kind of just a Lou Will type player, which is another player who could be on this list. I mean, he's a good scorer, and that's about it. And De'Aaron Fox, I feel like he's perfectly rated as he is. He's a great young point guard. He's going to be one of the top point guards in the league after, you know, Russell and Dame and CP3 and all those guys kind of plateau a little bit. I think De'Aaron will be up there with one of the best point guards in the league. So those are some players that I left off the list. Make sure you comment down below some other players that deserve to be on this list. But in my opinion, this player will definitely show his true colors this next season. Rushing it.